Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to cover the topic cleaning equipments. Myself, Paramveer Singh, Associate Professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. In today's video, we'll talk about purchase, use and care of various equipments which are used in housekeeping department. So let's begin. Selection criteria for purchasing cleaning equipments. Cleaning equipments are essential tools for housekeeping professionals. They help to improve productivity and efficiency of the department as well as the workers who are working there, because their work will become easy and they can easily do a job with the help of various equipments. As equipment is expensive, their selection is of utmost importance. The correct choice and quality of equipment could save the cost of breakdowns, labor and time. During the purchase of equipments, the following points we have to keep in mind, and it goes: quality of equipment. By ascertaining the history of their use in the organization, it should be tested for its performance. We have to test the equipments first and then we have to go for the purchase. Safety in operations. Are they safe to use? Suitable to the type of surface area or work, amount of obstruction and cleaning frequency. Versatility to undertake various types of cleaning. So these points we have to keep in mind during the purchase. Work performance in terms of capacity of machine and consumer reports on maintenance. Various kind of maintenance which are required for the equipments that we have to keep in mind. How much work the machine can do in one stretch, that we have to keep in mind. Ease of handling of the equipments is an important factor, as they should not physically overload the operators. The machines or the equipments which you are using, they should be easy to handle, easy in maintenance. And the cost factor also matters in terms of equipments what you are going to purchase for the hotel. Availability of parts and accessories. The after sales services are very much important. If you purchase a machine and then the spare parts are not available, then it will be of no use. Portability in terms of ease of transfer between floors and provision of wheels and detachable parts. Machine should be easily movable. It should have casters or wheels, and so that you can easily transfer it. Durability in terms of usage. It should be durable to use. Appearance is most important, as the equipment will be in the view of the guest. The equipments what you are using, you have to use them in the front of the guest. So they have to be proper, in good shape, as well as they should be elegant, so that you can keep you can take them in front of the guests. Noise level, which is a more important consideration for hospitals than hotels. Machines which you are using, they should be they should produce less noise, so that you can use them in hospitals as well as in the hotels, in the corridors where there are certain rooms which are on D&D. Rules for storage of equipments. To give equipment a longer life, they have to be handled with care. Handled with care so that you can use them for the longer duration. One criteria for care is their storage. If storage is proper, the lifespan of an equipment will be more. Given below are some strong storage tips. The store should be dry and well ventilated, as dampness causes rust and mildew, leading to degeneration of equipments. The room where you are storing the things, it has to be proper ventilated, so that the dampness or the mildew, the vapors of the water, should evaporate easily, or else your equipments will get damaged. The store should be properly locked to prevent pilferage or to prevent misuse. Buckets must be clean and dry before storage. Brushes and brooms should not rest on their bristles. All detergents and polishes must be properly sealed before storage to prevent evaporation or drying. Mops must be wrung and dried before storage. Mops, the wet mop, you have to be squeezed properly and then you put it for drying. There should be adequate racks and cupboards properly labeled for easy identification. In case someone else from housekeeping needs something and he visits that particular storage area, so all the tagging should be done properly. All the you can say the labeling has to be done properly so that it is easy for anyone to identify the equipments. Equipment must be cleaned thoroughly prior to storing. Equipment accessories must be labeled and kept preferably in cupboards. Stock records should be maintained showing the following: date of purchase, kind of stock and quality, name of the supplier, cost per unit, date of issue into service, remarks on suitability and durability. These are the things which you have to maintain in your stock registers or inventory registers as well, so that in case you require new things, you should know the name of the supplier or the cost of the unit. For the proper control of equipments, their issues from the store must be followed certain rules. Equipment must be issued at definite times. New issues must be made strictly against the worn out equipments. The store must be subject to regular inspection and audit. Expensive equipment must be covered in polythene to protect them from dust during storage. You need to hand over the damaged or the worn out equipments to get the new ones. It should be on give and take basis. Equipment should be issued at a particular time and the storage has to be inspected time to time. Categories of cleaning equipments. Cleaning equipments must be divided into two broad categories, that is manual equipments and mechanical equipments. So cleaning equipments, under this we have two headings, that is manual and mechanical. Under manual you will have brushes, brooms, mops, box sweepers, clothes, polish applicators, containers and sundry equipments, various other equipments. Under mechanical you have vacuum cleaners, scrubbing and polishing machines, wet extraction systems, carpet shampooing machines, scrubber or dryer sweepers, high pressure washers and scarifying machines. So let's begin with this. Manual equipments. Manual equipments can include all type of equipments that clean or aid in the cleaning process by directly using maneuver operations and energy of employee. So the equipments which are used by hands and which are not used with the help of electricity, that all those things falls under this. So let's begin. First we have brushes. These may be designed to remove dry or wet or ingrained dust and dirt from hard or soft surfaces. There are three types of brushes: hard brushes, soft brushes and scrubbing brushes. Hard brushes have bristles that are fairly stiff and well spaced out. They are most suitable for removal of heavy soil and litter from carpets and for cleaning rough surfaces. The bristles of these brushes are hard and they are stiff. Soft brushes have bristles that are fairly flexible and set close together. These help to remove loose soil and litter on hard or smooth surfaces. Such brushes may be designed to dust carpets and furniture too, especially those made of cane, wicker, or bamboo. Scrubbing brushes are basically the brushes which have short or coarse bristles designed for use on surfaces that have become stained and heavily ingrained with dirt. These brushes should only be used to remove stubborn, heavy soiling from small areas that are difficult for a scrubbing machine to access. So the area where machine doesn't reach, these brushes can be used on the surface to clean them. Brushes are also classified on the basis of their functions: toilet brush, bottle brush, cloth scrubbers, carpet brushes, floor brushes, upholstery brushes, feather brushes, and sink brushes. So as by the name itself, you can see that what are the use of these brushes and where they are supposed to be used. Care of the brushes. Brushes should never rest on their bristles. You don't have to put the bristles on the brushes on the bristles. After use, they must be cleaned and fluff or cotton bits should be removed. Anything which is cleaned from the by the help of brushes, it has to be removed from the brushes. Brushes must be washed with soap leather by working the bristles up and down in warm water, and rinse clean with cold water and dried in sun. Brushes must be dry when stored. Next, broom. Sweeping brooms consist of long bristles gathered together and inserted into a handle. Depending on the type of brooms, may be used for removing dust or dirt in large areas. There are two types of the brooms of various types. As with brushes, brooms may be classified into three main categories: soft bristle brooms or soft brooms, hard or coarse bristle brooms or hard brooms, and wall brooms. This is a soft broom. Soft bristle brooms are used on smooth floors like your tile or marbles or concrete floors, which are plain. Hard brooms, this is a hard broom, the normal hard bamboo broom or the normal brush, the long handle broom. Brooms such as yard brooms and coconut fibers brooms are used on coarse surfaces, especially outdoors. Wall brooms are the ones which have a Turk's head. These are also called ceiling brooms, which are used to clean the higher areas. They have a soft head and a long handle, usually made of cane. These brooms are used to remove cobwebs as well as dust from cornices, ceilings, and other places. How to take care of brooms? Brooms should be shaken free of dust and fluff. After use, you have to shake the broom so that whatever dust particles are there, they should be removed from it. Never store them standing on their bristles. Otherwise, the bristles will bend out of shape, resulting in inefficient cleaning process. Store brooms lying horizontally or hanging bristles downward. Either you have to store them on the ground in a horizontal position, or you have to hang them with the handle towards the top and bristles towards the ground. Never use soft brooms on wet surfaces. Stiff brooms such as the coconut fiber brooms can be used on wet surfaces, but must afterwards be cleaned thoroughly in saline water and dried in the sun before storing. So in case you have used soft broom on the wet surface, you have to dry it before storing it. Next is mops. Two types of mops are there: dry mops and wet mops. Dry mops consist of a head of various shapes and sizes made from soft twisted cotton yarn or synthetic fibers and attached to a long handle. The synthetic fibers are electrostatic and attract the dust. The dry mops are the ones which can be used in place of brooms in the inside the room or in the hotels. Some cotton mop heads are impregnated with a dressing which causes dust to adhere to the mop more satisfactorily. The large mops are known as sweepers. Mops consist of a double hinged frame or called V-sweepers or scissor action sweepers. These are the mops. Dry mop in the first picture, and the second picture is a V-sweeper where you can catch the dust with the help of a scissoring action. The care and cleaning of the dry mop. Shake mops well after use in outdoors. The mop head should be easily detachable so that they can be frequently washed in hot water with detergent. After cleaning the mop, it should be tightly squeezed out, shaken well to get rid of excess moisture and left to dry in open air. Once dry, the mops may need to be re-impregnated. They need to be reattached to the handle and can be and are ready to use again. Wet mops and spawn mops are used for cleaning lightly soiled floors in conjunction with a bucket, hot water and detergent. The mop consists of long coarser cotton yarn than a dry mop, and a sponge mop is another type of wet mop. Another type of wet mop is squeezy, which consists of a long metallic handle and a wooden or a rubber blade to remove excess water from a surface being cleaned. It is effective when followed by mopping with a damp mop. A smaller version called the window squeezy is used for wiping away water from the windows after washing. A sponge mop and a wet mop. The picture of both are there in front of your screen. This is a squeezy which is used to remove extra water from the window panes or from the floor. Care and cleaning. Take mops outdoors after use and shake well to remove excess moisture. Then these mops may be washed in the same way as dry mops. Detachable heads are easier to clean and maintain. However, drying is the most important part of mop care, as bacteria require moisture to multiply. Damp mops should be renewed as soon as there are signs of wear and tear. They should be stored in such a way that air is allowed to circulate around the mop head. That is very much necessary. Wash and rinse sponge heads after use. Squeeze out excess water and dry them well. Store the sponge head by hanging downwards. Next is box sweeper. These are also called carpet sweepers and are used for the removal of surface dust and crumbs from carpets. A box sweeper consists of a friction brush placed in between the two dust pans that revolves when the equipment is pushed manually over the carpet. The dust gets thrown up into the built-in dustpans. This is the picture of a box sweeper. Care and cleaning of the box sweeper. The friction brush should be kept clean, else the efficiency of the equipment will be seriously impaired. After the cleaning process, the dustpans should be emptied of all the collected dust. That's all for today, and in the next class we will talk about rest of the mechanical, or sorry, the manual equipments. Thank you and have a nice day.